For any democracy to be long-lasting, it needs free and diverse media. Media being recognized as the fourth state in addition to the legislature, judiciary, and the executive is an important medium for both state and citizens. Ethiopia took its first step forward towards assuring the freedom of speech in 1955. It was given a judicial recognition with the revised constitution at the time. The 1974 draft constitution and the 1987 constitution of the People's Democratic Republic of Ethiopia followed suit in recognizing the concept. More than half a century has gone by since freedom of expression has been introduced in the country, but the question still remains, has the constitutional guarantees of the concept fostered political dissent and freedom of the press?
Freedom of expression is a constant threat, and people will, when you write some critical article, people will come to you and tell you that, why are you mad, you are playing with fire, why do you write these kinds of critical articles? So even Facebook posters are being monitored in Ethiopia in current situation, so freedom of expression is at risk in Ethiopia.
So we cannot argue that totally or fully the constitutional right for freedom of expression is respected, but in relative terms and in comparison to our history, in historical comparison, relatively it is respected, but sometimes we see when it is violated.
The right given under Article 29 is not totally respected in Ethiopia, and it got different reasons for that, and there are different laws which contradict to the constitution. The first reason is that. The second reason is the political sphere, which gives citizens, journalists, operational room is not wide as expected, and it's getting narrow and narrow from time to time.
የኢትዮጵያን ህገ መንግስት ብዙ ፖዚቲቭ እንትኖች አሉት፣ አንቀጾች አሉት። ከነዚህ ውስጥ የሚጠቀሰው አንዱ የመናገር ነጻነት፣ ለፕሬስ ነጻነት የሚሰጠው ትልቅ ቦታ ነው። ምክንያቱም ፕራክቲካሊ በሌሎች ህጎች ይደመሰሰዋል።
እኔ አልተከበረም ብዬ ነው የማስበው፣ ምክንያቱም ብዙ ማሳያዎች አሉን እንዳልተከበረ። በማስረጃ የሪዮት አለሙ ነች፣ የሪዮት አለሙ ታናሽት ነኝ። ስለዚህ እሷ ህያው ማስረጃ ነች ለኔ ለዚህ ይሄ ነጻነት አልተከበረም ብዬ። ምክንያቱም ሪዮት ሐሳቧን በነጻነት ነበር የምትገልጸው። በዚህ ተነሳም ነው ደግሞ ለስር የተዳረገችው።
The situation of freedom of expression in Ethiopia has been wanting. It falls short of the constitutional obligations and the international obligations that Ethiopia has signed onto voluntarily.
አራሱ ማስረጃ እንግዲህ ያው ባሌ ነው። ምክንያቱም በፊት ያው ቢሰራቸው ስራዎች የታወቁ ናቸው። ከቤተሰቡንም የተደበቀ ነገር የሚሰራው ነገር የለም። ከሙያው ጋር በጣም ስቲኮ ነው ብዙውን ጊዜን የሚያሳልፈው፣ እና ያንን ደግሞ አውቃለሁ ከማንም በላይ እኔኝም አውቀው።
In similar to freedom of expression, access to information is given a very good proclamation in the 2008 proclamation, but it is not yet respected as it should be. Media personnel, especially journalists, are always prohibited to access information in regard to government offices and the like.
ህገ መንግስቱ ለመናገር ነጻነት እውቅና ሰጥቷል። ነገር ግን ወደ መሬት ስንወርድ አሳዛኝ ነገር ነው የምታየው። ኢትዮጵያ ውስጥ የመናገር ነጻነት ምንም አይነት የመንግስትን ጥበቃ አያገኝም።
እርግጥ ነው በግልጽ ተቀምጧል የመናገር ነጻነት መብት አለ ተብሎ በየጊዜውም በይፋ ይነገራል። ፕራክቲካሊ ግን መሬት ላይ ወርደን ያለውን እነት ስናየው ግን ይሄ ነገር አለ ወይ? ሙሉ በሙሉ አራት ነጥብ የለም በሚል ደረጃ ላይ ነው የምናገኘው።
ህገ መንግስት ላይ ነበር ያለው የመናገር ነጻነት ተከብሯል ብዬ አላስብም። የሚወጡ አፋኝ ህጎች የመናገር ነጻነትን በስትክክል ላይ ተገበር እንቅፋት ሆኗል ብዬ አምናለሁ።
A number of human rights groups, including Article 19, have revealed that several journalists have been convicted with terrorism charges in the country to date. Journalists also complain about government interference and harassment, and dozens of working journalists in Addis Ababa protest for being beaten or detained on charges of terrorism, inciting opposition and other accused.
Ethiopia ust ngidi afanawun miyakayid yallo mengist nu ጥያቄ እናንተን የለው ሌሎች አካባቢዎች ላይ ሌሎች ታጣቂ ቡድኖች ሌሎች የተለያዩ ኤክስፒሪየንሶች ኖር ይችላሉ ኢትዮጵያ ውስጥ ግን ጥበቃ ማድረግ ያለበት መንግስት ነው እንትን የሚያደርገው
for example we can see the legal case of a few journalists in prison we can take Bushetaye we can take Rotalemu and we can take Iskender Naga those are all of their charges are by the anti-terrorism law it's really clear that this direct related with their freedom of expression and the reason is why the way they express themselves which makes them be in jail and regarding to the other friends and colleagues around and we know some colleagues facing different intimidations and harassments by expressing their views only by expressing their views and some of them got also detentions and in-person intimidations
currently Ethiopian journalists are under threat and they are forced to operate under constant threat of different kinds of fear so they are forced to operate in a fear and they're doing their journalism in a very hostile environment we know that journalism is one of the least respected and practiced profession in Ethiopia because of different circumstances in Ethiopia because we got from since 2011 we got more than 6 journalists sentenced into prison for purely journalism activities so journalists are operating under serious environment which is very hostile which is not friendly and which is very dangerous at some instances and some of them are forced to be in exile some of them are forced to be in Ethiopia but the situation is very serious it's a very grave situation and a sad situation
media houses are banned journalists are arrested charged against in the name of the anti-terrorism proclamation and so many examples could be given even in the broadcast media television is not television license is not given to any Ethiopian media agency independent agency so I can name a lot of examples that can tell the constitution the rights that are written on the constitution are not respected
while of the rest of the country would have people who are being treated below standard because of the colonial legacy we expected that Ethiopia would be a bright torch to the rest because it resisted the colonization of its people showing that it valued its own independence it valued its own dignity but it's sad that today as we speak there are over 7 journalists in prison it's sad that more than 73 publications have been banned and more than 21 journalists have been prosecuted on crimes that we think are frivolous crimes that we think have been made up by state security agencies purely to send a chilling effect for any journalist who's willing to ask hard questions so that makes Ethiopia one of the countries that are not faring very well
in terms of government for example the press law which is enacted after the 1999 after the 2005 election along with the other three laws enacted in the aftermath of the election that's I mean kind of sort of restricting the freedom of expression in Ethiopia which was constitutionally granted
gazetenyoch weim hasabachewun benesanet yemigelsu ሰዎች አስተያየታቸው ወይም ሐሳባቸው ከገዢው መንግስት የተለየ ከሆነ ባይኒ ሚንስ ሊታሰሩ ይችላሉ ከሀገር ይሰደዳሉ ይገደላሉ የመኖር የመስራት ዋስትናቸው ሊያጡ ይችላሉ
At least 11 journalists have been charged with terrorism since November 2011 more than 17 newspapers were forced to close because of government pressure during the two decades according to a number of human rights groups research Independent TV stations are not yet allowed, with only 2 private FM stations functioning in the country. As a result, the question of media plurality seems in controversy.
Even when you compare it with our neighbor Kenya, that they have a lot of media outlets, they have lots of dailies with circulation of 100,000, which you can't put that figure when you put all the newspapers together in Addis. So it's one of the worst situation. The Daily Nation, for example, the Daily Kenyan newspaper, of the circulation which is around 100,000. We don't have that figure. If you put all the weeklies, all the dailies in Ethiopia, if you have that, we can't have that kind of number here in Ethiopia. For the last 20 years, this time is one of the worst period of freedom of expression.
Especially after the 2005 election, and it's really difficult to get so many magazines and the newspapers in Ethiopian media sphere. And additionally, there are so many charges on the journalists, and journalists are being arrested by the anti-terrorism law, and they are getting convicted for more than 10 years. And taking these things into consideration, I think the situation is deteriorating from time to time. And currently we have only a couple of magazines and the newspapers for more than 80 million people.
1% እንኳን ይሆናል በያለስብም የዚህን 10 እና 15 ጥፍ እንኳን የሚዲያ ተቋሞች ብትመሰረት ካለን 80 ምናምን ሚሊዮን ለሚሆን ህዝብ በቂ ነው በያለስብም.
In the broadcast media, television license is not given to any Ethiopian media agency.
Exposing the truth and reporting with integrity, these journalists risk being imprisoned and putting the life of their loved ones on the line.
Guys, any net Ethiopia us baunu saat waga mikefelbet moya no. Lemisale and wotader mejemera mutidirnawnu simertim kendegena sigabam miyacho riskoch allu. Mekniyatum way agar litabek no miedew, selezi እሱ የሚተኩሳል ከዛ የሚተኩስበታል ሊሞት ይችላል ያው ዞሮ ዞሮ አደጋ ውስጥ አርጎ ነው የሚሄደው በዛ ደረጃ ነው የምታየው መንግስት መቼ እንደሚያስራ አታቀም ግን እንደምትታሰር ውስጥ እየገመትክ ነው የምትሄደው ጋዜጠኝነትን ባጭር ቃል በቃ ፈታኝ ሆኖ ዋጋም የሚያስከፍል ሙያ ሆኗል ኢትዮጵያ ውስጥ
the main constraint is the law itself the new press law which a lot of people are asking I mean are trying to reform it, like the anti-terrorism law. That's one of the constraints, which is a legal constraint. There are administrative constraints. Sometimes journalists are attacked. Some journalists are harassed, arrested arbitrarily. That is one of the administrative constraints. And journalists are not well protected. That's the biggest constraint here.
Journalists are operating under serious environment which is very hostile, which is not friendly, and which is very dangerous at some instances. And some of them are forced to be in exile, some of them are forced to be in Ethiopia, but the situation is very serious. It's a very grave situation.
Ethiopia us yallu gazetenyoch bene emnet bandim ihun belela menger gejiun party weme hadegin ታከው ወይም በሱ ጥላ ስር ተጠልለው እስካልሰሩ ድረስ በእስር ቤት ወይም በሞት በር ላይ ሆነው ነው የሚጽፉት ስለዚህ ይሄ ነው እነታው ይሄ ነው በእስር ቤት ወይም በሞት በር ላይ ሆነን ነው እየሰራን ያለን ይህች ሀገር አገራችን ናት ስለዚህ ለሀገር የሚሰማም እንደጋዜጠኝነት ብቻ ሳይሆን እንደጋዜጠኛ ብቻ ሳይሆን እንደዜጋም ይህች ሀገር ሊኖራት ስለሚገባው መልካም አስተዳደር ለትደርስበት የሚገባው ዜጎቿ ሁሉም በአንድ አይነት መንገድ የሚዳኙበት የፍትህ ስርዓት እንዲኖር ከመመኘት አንጻር ተሰራለህ ነገር ግን እጣፈንታ እንደነገርኩ ወይ እስር ቤት መወርወር ነው አለም መገደል ነው
Many people and organizations around the world have spoken on behalf and in defense of Ethiopian journalists who are imprisoned in related to anti-terrorism law CNN Multichoice African Journal Awards independent panel of judges view that multi-award winner journalists like Wibshat Taye and his colleagues Riot Alamu and Iskander Nagga should be out of prison and working to build the prosperity and freedom of the new Ethiopia. The family members of the imprisoned journalists forward their opinions on the matter.
ani fetarobbi neger yaw malakti yone confused mi yareg neger na andenya alamaqaf entanu shellemotal bemoyo no igebwal tikkelenya waga yekefelen yallo biye no masbo ለመሸለሙ እኔ ፈጠረብኝ ነገር አንደኛ የሱ ሞራል ከመጠበቅ አንፃር በጣም ነው ደስ ያለኝ መንግስት ወይም የሚመለከተው አካል መፍትሄ ቢሰጥበት ብዬ ነው ማስበው
ዋካቹ የሰው ሰባይ መብት ይከበር ነው ማለት ምክንያቱም አጠፉ ተብለው እንኳን ታስረው ያለ መብታቸው አልተከበረም እነዚህ ሰዎች ቢያንስ የሰው ሰባይ መብታቸው ቢከበርልን ህክምና ቢፈቀድላቸው ታስረው ያሉ እንኳን ቤተሰብ እንዳይጎበኛቸው የሚደረገው ነገር ቢቀርና ቤተሰብ ቢጎበኛቸው ሌላው ደግሞ ለዓለም አቀፍ ድርጅቶች ማስተላልፈው ይሄ ጨዋታቸውን አሁንም ቢቀጥሉበት ይሄን መንግስት በደንብ ተጭነው ቢሰሩ ደስ ይለኛል.
Article 19, based on its mandate, is playing its part for protection of freedom of expression and access to information in Ethiopia.
We need media pluralism and diversity of voices on the media outlets that exist. So we advise and share with governments policy guidelines and legislative guidelines on how to make progressive laws that are in line with international standards that they have signed on to and international best practice or promising practice, how to move forward. On the other level, we also engage with civil groups in showing them how understanding their rights and responsibilities on freedom of expression is a precursor to them realizing all other rights. Fundamental to exercising all other rights is freedom of expression. So for journalists, we've done a number of things. One is to help them understand the legal framework within which they work, to be able to know what are their rights within law and what are their responsibilities within law. So to be able to exercise their profession legally. We've also been able to help them understand basic security skills that they need.
Two alternatives lie ahead for the future of freedom of speech in the country. At the end of the tunnel awaits a bright glow or a dim light with no value for democracy.
As an activist for freedom of expression say that government should lead us to present what we have to do what the proper journalism asks us to do and let the people judge us, not the government. We know that, you know, there were highly regarded newspapers with the top circulation numbers and they're gone. 2 years, 3 years, they're gone. 2 years, 3 years, they're gone. This has been a practice for the last at least 15 years. So we want the government to let us judged by the society.
ጓደኞቼ ጋር መቼ ሆነ መገናኘው ነው ማለት በጣም ይናፍቁኛል አስሚ እነቴ ነው ምነግር የእነቴ ነው ትንሽ ስሜት አይውቅ ገባ ይናፍቁኛል በጣም ገባ እና መቼ ነው ከነሱ ጋር ምን እንገናኝ መቼ ነው ስለ ድሯችን እናወራው መቼ ነው ያንን የፍቅር ጊዜ እናስታውሰው ነው ትንሽ ይናፍቀኛል.
We don't have to only see the freedom of expression separately from other rights, and the rights related things are getting deteriorated in Ethiopia. For example, you can see the anti-terrorism law directly affected the freedom of expression. Therefore, it's not only about the freedom of expression, it's directly related with the human rights, current human rights situation in Ethiopia.
The government should start to give the credit for the press, not repress them, not push them or throw them in the jail for members of the private press. So government should strengthen the private press for the sake of democracy, for the sake of development. So please, the message is that the government please start to consider giving the credits for the repressed society, which is journalists of Ethiopia.